So I often joke the only real problem with shooting snowflake photography is you have to shoot it when it's cold outside. Snow, when it's falling and just hit the ground, is actually the best time to shoot snowflakes. There's a process called sublimation, which occurs even below freezing temperatures, that causes snowflakes to start to lose their structure within an hour or so of actually hitting the ground. Now, the ideal temperature to shoot snowflakes is less than 25 degrees. That leaves the snowflake intact for a period of time. The closer you get to 32 degrees or 0 degrees centigrade, the closer you're going to get to having snowflakes melting within seconds or a minute of having landed. So get out there when it's cold. That's really, really key. Now, how do I capture my snowflakes? What kind of background do I use? Well, it's all thanks to this woolen sock. That's really what I shoot with. Now, the benefit of the sock is it has lots of fibers, and so when the snow is falling, and I usually have it horizontally, these snowflakes get caught up on the fibers. These aren't going to matter when I actually do the final snowflake photos, but they're actually really important for giving a nice black backdrop. Now, occasionally I'll capture snowflake photos on the wood of our deck or on surfaces, but really the ones like the one you saw at the very beginning were captured entirely using a black wool sock. I know it's kind of strange. Now, what does it look like when it hits the sock? The key is, for me, when it lands, I'm going to be looking for the best snowflakes that I can find.